We learned in the previous video that beta-carotene is one of the top 5 anti-inflammatory food components in the Dietary Inflammatory Index. In this short video, we'll take a look at how beta-carotene has been linked to various positive health outcomes and how you could obtain sufficient amounts in your diet. Hi, I'm Chung, a qualified nutritionist with a master's in nutritional sciences, here to share with you the latest evidence-based findings on healthy eating and living. Beta-carotene is one of the main sources of vitamin A that we can obtain from plant foods, with the highest amounts found in foods such as carrots, pumpkins, spinach, mustard greens, and sweet potatoes. Vitamin A then plays an important role in maintaining a healthy gut barrier and gut immune system, both of which will help to reduce chronic inflammation in the gut. In fact, the levels of beta-carotene circulating in our blood has been consistently linked in various studies as a biomarker for healthy eating patterns, such as the Mediterranean diet, that have been associated with positive health outcomes. For example, in this study, higher levels of circulating beta-carotene was associated with greater adherence to this particular healthy pattern of eating. How else has beta-carotene been associated with positive health outcomes? In this meta-analysis of 7 prospective studies with about 150,000 participants, highest intake of beta-carotene from foods compared to lowest intake was associated with a 17% lower risk of dying from all causes. When the analysis was performed on blood levels of beta-carotene, which is a more accurate marker compared to intake levels measured by food questionnaires, highest levels of circulating beta-carotene compared to lowest levels was associated with a 31% lower risk of dying from all causes. What about specific health outcomes such as for cardiovascular disease? This other meta-analysis showed that highest versus lowest intake of dietary beta-carotene was associated with a 27% lower risk of developing coronary heart disease and a 16% lower risk of having a stroke. Further analysis showed that for every 5 mg per day increase in dietary beta-carotene, the risk of developing coronary heart disease and having a stroke were lower by 18% and 19% respectively. In fact, based on the global average and standard deviation in the Dietary Inflammatory Index, to enjoy the maximum anti-inflammatory benefit of beta-carotene, one should consume about 9 mg per day of beta-carotene. So, what will you need to eat to obtain 5 to 10 mg of beta-carotene per day? Before I go into that detail, if you've learned something in this video, do help me by hitting the subscribe and the like buttons and turn on the notifications. It would be even more amazing if you could share this video with just one other person. So, what would contain 5 to 10 mg of beta-carotene? 1 cup of cantaloupe would have about 3 mg of beta-carotene. 1 cup of pumpkin or 1 medium carrot would both have about 5 mg. 1 cup of cooked spinach or 1 cup of cooked mustard greens would have about 10 mg. And 1 medium sweet potato would have a whopping 17 mg of beta-carotene. As such, getting between 5 to 10 mg of beta-carotene per day is quite achievable by incorporating some of these foods into your routine. I hope you enjoyed this short introduction to beta-carotene. In these other videos, I'll explain what is chronic inflammation, as well as do similar deep dives into some of the beneficial food components from the Dietary Inflammatory Index. Check them out now, and I'll see you next time.